Greetings! I am Herbert Erpaderp, and today I'm going to build this R75 motorcycle with Sidecar. This is a 28mm scale plastic kit from Rubicon Models. As the box tells us, this is the standard version, which is to say for European theatres. There is another version of this kit for Africa. The video is a bit off-kilter, but you can see things well enough. The back of the box here shows a side-on illustration of the bike with some suggested Vallejo colours. You'll need more than two colours really, but it's a good start. There's also paragraphs about the bike and its role in the war, and an image of the included decal sheet which includes a lot of license plates. Inside the box we find three sprues. This large one has all of the bike and sidecar parts, while these two smaller ones have the crew. A rider and passenger, plus a gunner who will sit in the sidecar. He gets his own sprue for reasons. Maybe he's a bit smelly and nobody wants to share. These two figure sprues would be different for the Africa Corps version of this kit. Looking closer at these parts, they do look pretty good. The plastic is a bit dark and kind of shiny. That seems pretty normal of Rubicon and I don't see it as a problem, except when it comes to lighting for a video. Anyway, what matters is the parts are quite neat and tidy. There are mold lines of course, but they're pretty much negligible for the most part. The parts look very good and the detail is rather decent. It should be obvious to most, but this is a wargaming model. It can certainly be used as a display piece if you like. However, as a wargaming kit, some of the detail is bound to be either omitted or simplified. That's not a complaint, more just stating the obvious, which is less than obvious to some. All that said, the parts do look very nice and well detailed, and I think it's going to build up into a quite nice looking motorcycle. The sprues with the crew figures do look okay too, though they're a little bit less sharp than the bike sprue. This always seems to be the case with Rubicon's figures, and I guess it does make sense. People are more rounded and smooth, with less sharp edges than most vehicles have. These sprues also have slightly more significant mold lines, though they are still quite minor. These figures should look just fine when painted up, and I am going to include some of them in this build. I normally don't use the figures anyway. Also included with this kit is the decal sheet, which we had a glimpse of on the back of the box. You can see I wasn't kidding about the huge variety of number plates. There's also a good amount of other markings. This is bound to be useful for more than just this motorcycle. I guess it's not specifically a motorcycle decal sheet, it does say German light vehicles. Rubicon decals have always been quite good in my experience, so I'm expecting these to go on without any issues, and they'll be good to keep on hand for other vehicles as well. Also, we get instructions. These are particularly helpful if you want to know how the kit goes together without having to guess. They're pretty much what I would expect from Rubicon, which is a good, well laid out, and easy to understand set of instructions. It's clear where things are optional or should be done differently according to which version of the vehicle you're planning to build. Very good. How about we start building then? I begin by gluing the right side of the fuel tank into place. This is pretty simple. There's barely a hint of a join line along the top of the tank, and that should be hidden by the rider. This is followed by a thing. I'm not sure what this is. It could be an exhaust pipe with a cover, but I don't think so. Whatever it is, it goes on nice and easy. I follow that with the right side of the engine. There are mounting holes for the pipes coming off of this, and it's very easy to get into place. The same goes for the left half. The parts are more or less the same, though reversed, so try not to mix them up. It looks like quite a large engine. I guess they needed the power to perform the sickest jumps they could. With that in place, why not add a headlight? There's no choice of parts here, only the slotted blackout lamp, but that's okay. It goes on easily and looks quite good. I then add the front exhaust and, I guess, muffler part? That's what it looks like it might be to me. Whatever it is, it goes on in a specific way, which is the way I've done it. I then add the front forky suspension-y part to the front wheel. There are guides on the top of the wheel that the fork part can slot into. It's quite easy to get this on, but you might find you need to nudge it around a bit to get it to sit straight and neatly. I leave that for the glue to set for a bit, and then I add the stowage box to the left rear of the bike. Here is where we get to make a choice. There are two kinds of stowage boxes, the metal kind that I have used here, and a leather version. Both of them are good, but I chose the metal one because I thought it looked a bit more interesting, and it might be a bit more fun to paint as well. Then I decided the time was right to add the front wheel assembly. This is pretty simple. Like on the front wheel part, there's a set of slots on the hinge into which the forks go. The wheel part also contacts the frame at the bottom. This will certainly add some strength to the model, which is desirable in a gaming piece. I'm pretty sure there should be a bit more of a gap there in reality, but this works perfectly fine for me. That's the bike pretty much done, other than the handlebars. Before we get to those though, it's time to build the sidecar. I start this by adding this railing thing. This is where the machine gun will mount, and presumably functions as something for the sidecar rider to hold onto as well. You know, when doing those extra sick jumps. Nothing too tricky about getting this part into place. There are recesses on either side just to the front of the opening onto which it mounts. Then comes the spare wheel, which mounts onto the pin on the rear of the sidecar body like so. Nothing tricky about this either, though it does have a bit of play to it, so I nudge it until it looks like it's on nice and level. It's probably a pretty good idea to have a floor in a sidecar, and fortunately, one of those was included. The way this is shaped will make it very hard to put it on wrong. I then glue the support frame axle-y part to the bottom of the sidecar. There is keying here, which should stop you from putting it on the wrong way, but just in case, the leaf springs should be on the right and the long protrusions that join the motorcycle should be on the left. The wheel then goes on the right side. This part has keying, so it only goes on one way. There's a mudguard on this wheel part, and that would look silly if you mounted it with that guard on the bottom of the wheel. I follow that with the stowage boxes for the sidecar. I use the same metal ones as on the bike itself. I like the consistency of them all being the same, and it is probably rare that they would be mismatched, but I would wager that it happened at least once. What I'm getting at is, use the bags you think look best. I think that's a pretty neat looking sidecar. Why not attach it to the bike? There's a couple of mounting holes on the right side of the bike for this to mount into. There's also an extra piece of plastic that you could put here to add a bit more strength, as the instructions say, for when the model is used for gaming without a base. I have left that off, for now. I'm not that rough with my models, but I can always add it later if I decide that I need it. It takes a little bit of nudging to get the bike and sidecar to look nice and level with each other, but I got there in the end. I think it looks pretty good. And that is the vehicle pretty much done, except, again, for the handlebars. The driver has those, so let's build him. This isn't too hard. The torso is a single piece onto which the arms are glued. It would be silly to just glue these on with no consideration given to how it will interact with the bike, so I use the bike as a sort of test fitting guide. Once I'm happy with how the handlebars and arms are sitting, I remove the figure from the bike. In reality, I left it for a bit to give the glue time to set, but in this video, I immediately attach the head. I thought it would add some interest to have the rider's head tilted to the side a bit, as though he's just noticed something to his left. It could be a sick jump to take, or it could be the enemy. I think the figure actually looks fairly decent, though I did choose to omit the guy behind him, so I move straight onto the sidecar machine gunnersman. I start this by adding the magazine. This is obviously quite a tiny piece, and I'm glad I didn't manage to lose it. Also, I add the bipod, which is also a bit fiddly, but not too hard to get onto the gun. I don't suppose a bipod has much use on a moving motorcycle, but I guess it's there for when the gunner is dismounted. The gun mounts onto one of the bars of the sidecar, so I figured it was a good idea to put the body in the seat so that I could match the gun arm to the shoulder, while making sure it was still able to mount to the bar. The figure does sit a bit oddly, in my opinion, almost as though he's either starting to jump out of the sidecar, or he's just being bounced around. Either is possible, really. Once I'm happy with the fit, I remove the figure and then add the left arm. This is a bit fiddly to do, especially without knocking the gun arm out of place. Got there though. And then I added the head. I wanted to make this one facing to the left like the rider, but the way the neck was shaped didn't quite allow for it. That's okay though, he looks fine the way he is. Like I said before, I'm only building two of the three crew figures, and so that's the German R75 motorcycle with sidecar in 28mm scale by Rubicon Models completed. I'm very happy with how this has turned out. It looks pretty cool, and as far as the units for my German bolt-action army goes, it's fairly unique. I'm not entirely sure if there really is a use for it in my force, but you never know and it's nice to have anyway. I do like to have enough models to build any kind of list on those rare occasions when I do play bolt action. Of course, this model isn't specifically for bolt action, but it is a 28mm scale model, so it's totally suited to that game. You are of course free to use it for any games you like, or no games at all. The detail of this little bike is rather good. The driver and gunner do look a little bit soft and smooth, and they're a lot more shiny than the rest of the plastic, which might add to that smooth look. I think once paint is on, the difference between how the bike and crew look will disappear. I'm obviously no motorcycle expert, so I can't tell you how realistic this bike is, but to me it looks quite convincing. As I said earlier, this is a wargaming kit, and while perfectly fine for display as well, you should expect some detail to be simplified or omitted. I know I do say that a lot, but some people seem to have difficulty understanding the difference. Something else that's pretty typical of wargaming kits is the build being quick and relatively easy, and that is definitely true in this case. I didn't encounter any issues, and the build was quite straightforward and very enjoyable. I built this on stream a while ago, and I did manage to get it together in fairly short order, so I would imagine, if you wanted to, you could whip up a whole swarm of these bikes in an afternoon. The build was a lot of fun, in no small part thanks to the folks who were in chat. If you want to watch me build models like this one live, head on over to twitch.tv/Herbert_Erpaderp and give me a follow. That way you'll be notified when I go live. Drop in and say hello. It'll be good times. If that's not your thing, that's cool too. Either way, what do you think of this R75? Do you use them in your German army for whatever game system you might play? Do you prefer to make your guys walk, or perhaps ride in some other vehicle? Let me know in the comments below. Also, if you found this video helpful or in some way interesting, I would certainly appreciate it if you were to share it with others who might get some use out of it. And if you haven't already, why not subscribe, follow, ring the bell, become a YouTube member or patron, and all the other things you do on YouTube and social media. Links to all of my things are in the description below. And as always, I shall return soon, so until then, be excellent to each other and thank you for watching. Farewell.